In this lesson, we'll be making a custom slicer template that has visual elements which aren't available as a default in Excel. I'm going to be getting right into the nitty-gritty of the many options available to make our slicers look amazing. Quick warning up front, this is a bit of a tricky one to follow, so you might want to watch the demo a few times. I think you'll agree that the end result is fully worth it. Effectively, what we're going to do here is create our own template for a slicer and add it into the menu options at the top here so it sits alongside them. To do that, let's pick one of the slicers and set it back to the default value. So that's this light blue and dark blue option as I showed you earlier. Then we need to right click on it, and where there's a modify option, it's grayed out at the moment. That's because we can't change the preset ones that are in Excel. What we can do though is duplicate them, which effectively takes a copy, and then we can modify those ones. Let's click duplicate. And I'm going to call this goat slicer 2 because I've actually done this before and it actually sits in Excel, meaning that I can use it for other workbooks, which is really handy. Anyway, goat slicer 2, click OK for now. And you'll see at the top here, if I hover over here, I've got goat slicer 2. As a quick preview of the slicer template we're going to make, I'm going to choose the release year slicer here and I'm going to set it to goat slicer, which I've just said is my existing one that I've got set in Excel and I use that for loads of different things. I'm going to show you step by step how to get back to that. So for now, let's set this slicer back to a template of goat slicer 2, the one we've just made. Make changes to the slicer template, just right click on our one and click modify. That's the option that wasn't there earlier, but now is because we've created our own custom template as a clone of an existing one. Let's click on whole slicer, format, and then click this gray here and click OK. This should be a gray that matches our left sidebar. I'm going to go in and out of the slicer modify option so I can show you the impact of the changes we're making as we go. Let's click OK and you can see that the whole background of the slicer has changed to match the left grey sidebar. If we click away for a second, we can see that there's a very subtle blue border around the slicer. So let's go back in, slicer, right click, modify, and let's do whole slicer, format. This time we're going to go into border and we're going to click none. Click OK. Click OK again, and you'll see that that border has now disappeared. The title release year being in a black font doesn't show up very well now on our grey background. So to change that, let's go back in, slicer, we're going to click on modify. This time we're going to go into header, format, we're going to click font and change it to white. That section at the top above our actual data section in the slicer is called the header, and that's where we need to change the formatting. Click OK again, and you can see it's now changed to white. Now let's have a play around with some of the selectable options in a slicer. At the moment, we can see that 2018 is blue because it's selected, and the other options, 2017 and 2016, are available options to select, but they're not currently chosen. Change that, let's go back into slicer, right click, modify, and you'll see that it calls them out here. So we've got selected item with data and selected item with no data. We've also got unselected item with data and unselected item with no data. That's quite difficult to get your head around to start with. Earlier on, I showed you an option to hide all items that didn't have data. That makes this part way easier because we can just ignore anything with no data. So the important ones to us are selected items with data, which we currently know to be showing as a blue with a black font. We're going to go into there, change the font to black, and then we're going to change the fill color to white. Click OK. Click OK again, and you can see now it looks the same as the ones that are unselected. That's not great. So let's go back in, modify, and then we're going to put unselected item data, and we're going to remove or not remove because we can't do remove, we can't do transparent. So what we have to do is set it to the color that matches the background so it looks transparent. So as we did earlier, we're going to pick our gray here. We're then going to change our font to white. While we're at it, let's put a border on of white as well. Click OK, click OK again. We can now see that we've got selected items in white with a black font, and unselected items have a nice white border around them but are transparent. To apply our finished template to the other slicers, we simply click on them, hold Control, click on the other one, go into Slicer, and then just pick Goat Slicer 2 here at the top left, and that has now set all of our slicers to match. At some point during messing about, I've managed to take the columns off release year, so I'm going to add those back on now. Into 3, and then I'm going to tweak it so that everything closes up and we have a little bit more space for studio in case that grows in size. Finally, you might have noticed that the font used in the slicers is not the same as the font that's in the table, so there's a bit of inconsistency there, so let's change that. So let's go back into the slicer template, right click, modify, whole slicer, format, and we're going to choose a baddie or a bardie, I'm not sure. Click on that, click OK again, and you'll see that it's actually applied it to all of the slicers because they all are linked to that template. I know I said that was the final tweak, but a final tweak, I've noticed that the font looks a bit big compared to what's in the table. In the table, we've got font size 10, so I'm going to match that in the slicer settings. So back into modify, and we're going to go whole slicer format, and we're going to pick size 10 here. Again, it will apply it to the slicer template, which means it will apply it to all of our existing slicers. Click OK, that's much better and a consistent theme across the whole model. In the next lesson, I'll be showing you more on what slicers are all about and why they're such a valuable and important tool. Then we're going to start building our first chart.